Hey everybody.
Hey, hello, hello.
How are you today? So, we got Eat With More Love in the house
and entertaining ASMR.
We are still on our road trip in Fresno, California.
Yes, we are. And we're at the Triangle Restaurant.
Delicious burgers.
I'm eating a double cheeseburger, extra sauce, extra pickles.
And I got a single one.
Yeah.
Same thing. Ooh, that look good, don't it? I can just look at it right there. Ooh, okay. And we got some onion rings and some fries. Y'all see that up there? Yeah.
Right in your face. Grab one.
Grab one. Okay, so we're going to say our grace and get it in. Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for this food we're about to receive. Nourish our bodies. Take anything that isn't of you out of this food. In the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
So, we is having a ball out here.
We're having a good time. We're visiting some places. We grew up here.
Mm-hmm.
Tell you a little bit about Fresno, California. It is in the Valley of California. It's considered the country. Mm-hmm. I know a lot of people might say, California doesn't have a country. California has a country. And Fresno's like agriculture, maybe some farmers, and you know, it's just a hometown type of place.
You know, people used to ask me, when I told them I was from Fresno, do they still have buggies and carriages? I'm like, seriously?
They probably do.
Yeah, they do. They probably do somewhere, but it's not like that. It ain't that country. I ain't never seen one on the street. Put it like that. And I've been here, well, I was here a little while.
So this is a place, the Triangle is a place where our family home was right around the corner. I love this place for a couple of reasons. The hamburgers are so good. They have this special sauce on them. It's just different. And it's what you grew up on. So, of course, you love what you grew up on. And then, the most exciting part about it, it was born the month and year that I was born.
You gonna tell your age?
Nope. Not today.
So you won't know how long it been. And we ain't
if
far.
You really care, Google it.
Yeah. How about that? You're gonna be surprised if you do. Mm-mm-mm. You'll be surprised because she don't know nothing her age. That
not
part.
True. But thank you. That's
you
a
don't.
Sweet compliment.
You don't. So, and that's the truth. You know
so
how
sweet.
It is. We don't crack.
I'm
it's
grabbing some ketchup back here in case you're wondering what all this movement is about. But so. It's nice here today. It's
beautiful.
Probably in the mid to low 70s. Sun is out, shining, beautiful. It's just,
it is so nice because we just been talking to people and.
Yeah, messing with them kind of like.
Yeah, a little bit.
Trying to hear their story and. Which is fun when you're talking to people.
We done heard two since we've been here.
What?
Stories. Two stories.
A couple.
I know y'all can't see me. That french fry in my on my head.
Grab the french fry so you can see her. There you go.
So anyway, we were listening to people's stories. They tell us about being here. One guy said he'd been here for 70-something years. He said, I just don't know what I'm still doing here.
Tell him how he got here. What he doing here. When he gonna leave here?
We should have put him on camera.
Put him on camera. Mm-hmm. Have him share a burger and a story with us.
Right. Then we had another guy. His story was pretty long, too. He was...
Was he here 9 years? Or... He said it was 9 years lung cancer free.
Mm-hmm.
From Chicago.
Won't he do it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Very
he said
nice
he
guy.
Lived here, and then he went to Chicago, and then he came back, right?
Is that... No, I thought he was from... I don't know.
From Chicago?
I thought he was from Chicago. Oh, okay. Maybe.
Maybe so.
Oh, he said he left Chicago when his daughter was 11, and then when he returned back, she was 22, 23.
Uh-huh.
So, yeah.
And he was all, he was just happy. Happy guy, and he deserved to be happy being cancer-free that long. You know, I'm still here. Ooh, he good. Ain't he good?
So, I have to tell you guys a story about this, the triangle.
Okay.
When I was a little, like I said, we grew up around the corner. We used to run up here when kids could run the streets free without worrying about being kidnapped.
That part.
Back in those days, we used to run up here, place our orders. So the very first time my brother, who is 2 years older than me, placed his order, they by himself, he came up here, had his little money, placed his order. They said, okay, we'll call your number when your food is ready. So he ran back home, sat by the phone, waiting for them to call his number. And then we're like, what are you sitting here for? And then he like, they're going to call my number from the triangle when my food is ready. And so we're like, if you don't get your behind back up there and go get your food. So that was funny that he was.
That was funny.
Not knowing as a child that you're going to call your number call, over the microphone, not your phone number.
And so. Wait a minute. How did you think they know your number to call you at home?
That part.
Funny. Oh, that's cute, though. His first time coming by himself.
Her little thing.
Yeah. I mean.
But these hamburgers are good. They are a tradition, especially in this old area.
Old-fashioned little hamburger.
It's actually called the Triangle Drive-In. So it's like one of those little drive-in places. You can order on the inside or order on the outside. Mm-hmm. They have shakes and ice cream cones, the dipping cones where you dip them in the chocolate.
That's what I was going to talk about.
I might need to get one of those before I leave here today.
We used to try to save up our little change and come and get an ice cream or a shake or something from here. And we was right around the corner. So it was so close, we was just waiting to get something. Here you go. And I used to get off. Did you used to catch the bus to school? The school bus?
I drove to school a lot.
Okay. You special. We was in the same house. I used to get on the bus. She bougie and stuff. I got on the school bus and I got off right here on this street. And walking past here without getting something was not the business. So, I'm just saying. I used to love to get off, come right here, grab me at least a french fry, because the french fries is bomb too. Just get an order of fries and head to the house. For real though, she's bougie. Drive.
I just don't remember catching the bus.
You never caught the bus.
A couple of times.
Well, your brothers, you had older siblings.
I had older siblings, so.
That
I
was
probably
going to school.
Caught her,
and
right.
I wasn't always with her. So.
We're not in the same.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But when I did come over here, I would get on the bus. I probably wasn't supposed to, but I did. And why wasn't she giving me a ride?
All I know is I didn't have to catch the bus. So I don't know.
Oh, we wasn't at the same school. That was because I was ditching and I thought I was in school with you. I'm only a year younger, but I had to go to ninth grade. She was in,
10th high school.
Yeah. And our schools were, like, right across from each other, little ways down across the street from each other. So I would always go there because everybody was older than me. And they all was at the other school. And I was like, I need to go to the other school. Like I said, me and her are close. So it's like, I wanted to be over there with them.
At the high school.
I was so glad when they changed our middle school to the high school. Because then I didn't have to worry about nothing. I was there. I come early. You remember that? I didn't get out of school till 5 o'clock.
I don't know what you went through. I didn't go through that, so I don't
know.
No,
you
know.
Didn't. But do you remember when we had to go?
I went to the my elementary school was K to 8. And then in 8th grade, first it was K to 9. And so I went all the way to the 8th grade. When I went to 9th grade, they decided that they would separate the 9th graders. I went to an all 9th grade school. I don't know what you call that. It was just an all 9th grade school. And then high school was 10.
That was middle school.
10 to 12. It was not really middle school. It was almost high school. It was confusing. They didn't know what to do with the 9th graders. I guess they thought, y'all need to be by yourselves.
Mm-hmm. Like, they had a whole school by yourself.
Y'all is confused.
Mm-hmm. Remember?
Yeah. Hamilton. And so then, went to high school, so I don't know what you mean when you say you got out of school at 5 o'clock.
Mm-hmm. Let me tell you. At the Hamilton, they changed our hours. First, this is what they did. They had us going to school at 12, I think, or 11:50, something like that. Anyway, they changed the hours. And we had to go in the evening. And then they ended up switching us after they changed the hours to the high school. So it was 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th grade.
And so who took the school during the day?
The normal high school. They changed it. You don't remember?
They closed that?
They closed Hamilton.
And that's so when they closed Hamilton grade, and we moved. So you had to go to the high school after the high schoolers got out of school.
No, we were there pretty much while they was there too, because some of them were late. Not late, but not like us. We had to stay there till 5 o'clock.
I didn't know that.
Yes. Where was you at? Out of school gone. Because when she was probably there,
at home,
she
minding my business.
Right, driving a car home. I had to take the bus. But you know what? That didn't last for long. So I'm going to stop. I'm going to stop acting like I wasn't. I was very privileged as a child. I was driving my mama and grandma's Cadillacs and stuff.
Kind of spoiled. Because, you know, we had advantages.
We did have a lot
of advantages. We had a lot of advantages. We can't complain.
We did. That is the truth, and I kid you not. Not bragging or nothing like that, because we wasn't rich. None of that.
We thought we was rich.
People thought we were rich. We didn't. I didn't. People thought we were.
And we were rich. We were rich in love.
That part.
We were rich, and we were taken care of.
We were taken care of, very much so. Because, like I said, I was driving a Cadillac in the 9th grade, no, 10th grade, to school. And they was like, oh, can I have a ride? Girl, let me tell you.
But it's all good. Stories of growing up in Fresno.
That's just the stories. It's a whole bunch of stories in Fresno. But it's all good. I loved my childhood. I really did. It could have been better, but everybody's could have been better.
But I think I ate the hamburger.
I hate that hamburger.
We're gonna let y'all go. Thank you again.
No, don't go.
thank you again for watching. Remember, I'm entertaining ASMR.
And I'm eat with more love.
All right, y'all. Have a good one. Peace.